meticulous planning, tables.
In 1830, the prosperous industrial centers on the east coast of the United States of America were poorly connected to the mainland. Insufficiently developed toll roads and slow ship canals were the only options when making long journeys. Farmers, businessmen, and travelers lamented these long, arduous, and above all, unsafe transport routes. They were not only an inconvenience for travelers, but also shackles on an emergent nation's hunger to grow. But at this time, a development from England was taking its first steps and helped keep alive the hope of many cities in the East of reaching greater economic influence and growth.
I've been waiting for you. I'm Philip Evan Thomas. It's always been my dream to build a railroad to the Ohio River and beyond. That would help everyone, both the settlers and the natives. And I need your help with that. First of all, I have two tasks for you in order to build a base from where we can monitor further activities. But as I learned back when I was a bank clerk, the books must always balance. So take care to make a profit, even with these preliminary assignments.
This new fish swimming in our pond. Greetings from the beautiful city of Charlotte. What was your name again? Beautiful stranger, wasn't it? Well, that's what you look like. Just let me know if you need help push starting your trains.
Thank you. What's the deal with the station? Are you looking for a fight? Look, to be clear, I have nothing against strangers. Some of my best friends are strangers. But you're not from here, and New York is my city. That's where I do business. I say when the trains roll, where they're going, and why. As long as you don't get in my way, everything will be A-okay between us.
The bigger a city gets, the greater its demands get, too. At some point, the goods from the immediate area will no longer be enough. That's where the railroad comes in handy. Now select Baltimore to take a closer look at the city. I see our two competitors have introduced themselves to you. They have different approaches and so will behave differently. Basically, however, they want to expand their rail networks and make a profit just like you do. So stay on guard and don't let them take advantage of you. Baltimore, where the headquarters of our firm is located, has a large clothing industry. The city therefore needs a constant supply of fabrics. In New York, on the other hand, the fashion-conscious customers are waiting for deliveries of ready-tailored goods. Lay a rail line between Baltimore and New York so that the clothing produced in Baltimore can be delivered to New York.
Thank you.
I'll let you get on with your responsibilities. Stay alert. I will check on your progress from time to time. If you transport the clothing from Baltimore with your rail line, you will be making a considerable contribution to the growth of the industry. Everyone profits from that. Excellent. You could hire train crews in the staff dialogue window. Then you'll need to view the train details of the selected train to assign the staff to it. Now open the train details of your most important train and assign an engineer and a stoker to it. You don't have first call on cities, farms, or mines. Of course, your transport income will fall if your competitors connect these to their rail networks. Tracks, locomotives, buildings, and cash all increase the value of your company. And the higher this is, the higher the price of your company stocks. Just as other companies buy stocks from you, you were able to buy some from them. If you do that, you will profit from the success of your competitors. You should buy stocks via the company dialog window now. Thank you.
even know what you were bidding on?
You can have a few crumbs of my success.
This should stay just between us, as it's, well, not entirely legal. But we need to keep all of our options open. A saboteur has applied for a job with you. If you send him to one of your competitors, he will make trouble for them. This can also cause their stock price to fall. You don't have to deploy saboteurs to do better than your competitors. You could deal with them in a more classy and legal way. Take a look at which routes are more lucrative and will ensure you become the most important transporter there. By the way, your competitor, Don Lorenzo, is a bit of a gang boss. You can imagine that he has good connections to bandits and saboteurs, so it's much easier for him to deploy such characters. You should have learned the most important aspects of your position by now. I'll let you get on with your responsibilities. Stay alert. I will check on your progress from time to time.
Unfortunately, one of your trains didn't make it. Unfortunately, one of your trains didn't make it.
One day the railroad will reach all the way to the West Coast. Every day, huge crowds of people set out to cross the entire country, and the trains will continue to get faster. Don't look at me like that. We can't stop progress.
I've pulled some strings to see whether anybody wants to switch sides.
Did you know that I am speaking in Washington on behalf of some Indian tribes? They have granted me the title of Haiwanab, which means the benevolent one.
Are you looking to play with the big boys? So what now?
My spy brought me a real treat from your research department.
A station in the middle of nowhere? This is a non-starter.
It angers me that to this day, nobody has erected a memorial to our founding father, George Washington. I hope that the disputes about it will be over someday, and I'll be the first to make a donation towards it.
Don't worry. Your employees won't miss a thing with me. Promise.
Thank you.
My brother spent some time in England. His accounts of how the railroad is used in mining there fascinated me. However, in America, we have considerably greater distances to overcome. A mammoth task.
It looks like one of your trains has a problem.
Thank you.
big dream has become reality. Baltimore now has a direct connection to the Great Lakes. This will speed up the trade of goods and help bring more prosperity to the city. Congratulations, you're doing some excellent work and your company has greatly increased in value, just as I had hoped it would. I believe that the railroad will democratize mobility. It is a means of transport that should be open to all people. Not only because it is profitable, no, but because it opens up people's eyes to the world.
It looks like one of your trains has a problem.
Thank you.
I sent the spy over to you. Surely you don't mind.
When I tell people about my plans for the railroad, they only see the problems. Laying the tracks, maintenance costs, labor costs. As if a fleet of stagecoaches were cheaper. And don't tell me these mountains of raw materials are supposed to be transported by horses.
Thank you.
it looks like one of your trains has a problem. You understand your craft, I must admit. I hope that we will fight over land and rails for a long time to come.
For my friends on the East Coast, the Great Lakes are a long way away, and many of them never want to go there. This is because they have only just arrived in the New World.
Oh, this new locomotive looks adventurous.
But think about their children. They won't want to spend their entire lives on the East Coast when a vast land of unimaginable possibilities lies before them. Baltimore is growing and thriving. That is mainly thanks to the railroad that you built. Well done.
child, I already had a wooden train set. You too? Or do you still have it? It's worth reconsidering that decision.
I sent the spy over to you. Surely you don't mind.
Don't worry. Your employees won't miss a thing with me. Promise. Believe me, it isn't easy to survive in this world of men. These old men with beards and tailcoats think that the world is at their feet, and woman too. But they should not expect that from me. Oh dear, there seems to be a little problem with one of your locomotives. Some people think that I should hire a man to represent me in negotiations because I might not be taken seriously. But where's the fun in that for me? A little competition creates business, so my new station won't do any harm.
Unfortunately, one of your trains didn't make it.
Prosperity on the East Coast is growing. I like that, as there are many places there that are dear to me, especially Baltimore. But this wealth is also causing people to become lazy. I hope there will be enough people like me who feel the urge to travel farther west.
Going better for you than I'd expected.
There's another station here now.
Doesn't my new factory look simply marvelous? Competition creates business, so my new station won't do any harm. Did I allow myself to be lulled in by your good looks? That won't happen to me again.
Unfortunately, one of your trains didn't make it.
I'll tell you one thing. We should join forces. You're more on the ball than I had thought. Together we can conquer the world. No? Okay, your loss.
You won the auction? But what are you going to do with it now?
My parents immigrated here from Europe. I'm not sure exactly from which country. I can barely remember them. They died when I was 2 years old.
This technology is mine now. Thanks for your work.
You really should pay more attention to the maintenance of your locomotives. Following my parents' deaths, I was sent to an orphanage. Oh, I know what you think about orphanages, but I got lucky. It was located north of New York, and it belonged to an old married couple who devotedly cared for all the children. Let me show you how it's done.
I sent the spy over to you. Surely you don't mind. One of your employees was looking for a new position, so I've offered him a job.
Thank you for letting me have your staff, sweetheart. My childhood was not unhappy, but even as a young woman, I knew that I had to seize my own luck and that I couldn't rely on other people. When I was 17, I left the East Coast. It's probably just another one of your little mistakes, but could it be that you just placed a bid?
Baltimore is prosperous.
The trust in new technology and the art of the adventurous railroaders paid off. Within a few years, a patchy network of short railroad lines stretched from the coast to the Great Lakes, bringing new wealth and a period of dynamic change. Soon the first dreamers entered the scene, calling for a gigantic railroad link from the Atlantic to the Pacific, the so-called Transcontinental Railroad. But how is the most enormous project of the century to be funded and executed when the first step had only just been taken?